McCain, thank you very much for joining us today.
Thank you.
Obviously, first question, why are you here in Fargo?
Well, because I believe that Rick Berg will be a very important addition to the United States Senate. I've watched him here in the North Dakota legislature. I've watched him in the United States Congress. And I look forward to serving with him in the United States Senate.
Is this your first trip to North Dakota?
No, I've been here before on a few occasions, yes.
Okay.
I love being here in the summer.
On a 95-degree day.
This is Arizona weather.
And I'm very grateful for all the wonderful citizens of North Dakota who come in winter with us in Arizona.
And there's a lot of them.
Senator Hoeven, what does it mean to have a guest like Senator McCain here today for the Republican Party?
You know, I think it shows the importance of this race, and we appreciate him being here so much. John is an absolute leader in the Senate in foreign affairs, obviously, from a military standpoint, and he's an American hero. He's an icon, and we're thrilled to have him. And he's a good friend.
Across the country, this seems to be a rift among the Republican Party. What do you make of that in terms of, the more conservative Tea Party, fringe, you could call them, and the more mainstream Republicans?
I think one of the surprises to a lot of people, not so much to John and to me, has been the unification of the Republican Party behind Mitt Romney. I might point out that in West Virginia, 41% of the Democrat voters in the primary voted for a felon who was in jail rather than President Obama. So. I think the party is quite united, and frankly, part of that is, to be very candid, is because they want to have a Republican in the White House.
You mentioned Republican Rick Berg. You obviously know him a little bit. What do you think about the other Senate contenders? There's Democrat Heidi Heitkamp and Dwayne Sand, who's challenging Rick Berg this Tuesday.
Well. I think that Dwayne Sand is a fine man, and I think he served his country honorably. Rick has the ability to hit the ground running when he arrives in the United States Senate. He has a background of leadership in the legislature. He has a leadership role in the United States Congress. And so it's just that I think that Rick is ready to go at a time. If we regain control of the Senate and we have control of the House and the presidency, there will be an agenda that's going to require a lot of work on the part of all of us and the experience that Rick has.
And what about Heidi Heitkamp? What are your thoughts on her?
I don't know her at all. I don't have any thoughts except that I understand that she may have some difficulty in voting for Harry Reid, so I sympathize with her there.
What advice do you have for candidates running for Congress this year, such as Rick Berg?
Well, I think the important thing is to be candid with the people of North Dakota. Mm-hmm. I've been here enough to know that this guy was so successful as governor and in the Senate because he just tells it like it is. I think North Dakotans have grown accustomed to that.
What do you think is the likelihood that Republicans will take a majority in the Senate come next year?
I think right now it's too close to call. I think we have a slight advantage, but I also think we're going to be up late election night, and the nation will be watching North Dakota.
And why is that?
Because this was one of the key races that we need to win in order to gain control of the Senate. I'll be very frank with you. We need North Dakota to get to 51.
And in terms of the Senate and the House itself, there's a lot of partisanship and not a lot of bipartisanship. Mm-hmm. How do you get over that, and how do you bring people together to actually get work done?
More people like Senator Hoeven, more people like Rick Berg, who have served in the legislature, in his case governor, who know that you have to reach across the aisle if you want to get things done. And also, I think, over time, the American people are showing their strong disapproval of us not acting. Look, I don't want to give you a long answer, but we are facing a physical cliff. The debt limit has to be raised. The Bush tax cuts are expiring. The sequestration, which would destroy our national defense, and other issues. We are really looking at the edge of a cliff. It's going to require us to work together.
Have you ever seen the Senate or the House fractured?
Nor have I seen such low disapproval ratings.
And Senator McCain's a great example of somebody who has worked across party lines. And regardless of how this election comes out, we're going to have to do that. So when we talk about having Rick come down there, that's with the idea that we work together and we get after these big challenges we have. tax reform, entitlement reform, national energy policy, the right kind of health care that empowers people, all these things that get our debt and deficit under control and get this country going. And so Senator McCain is a leader, not just among Republicans, but in reaching out to Democrats and finding ways to craft bipartisan solutions. Look at some of the legislation that he's passed. It's with Democrats. That's what it's going to take to get things going.
Rick Berg has that experience in the legislature.
And a couple of presidential questions for you. Mm-hmm. What do you think the likelihood is that Mitt Romney will win the Oval Office in November?
I think we're going to be up late election night. I think it comes down to 6 or 7 states. I think he and Vice President Hoeven will have a real good chance.
And that's what I was going to ask, is who do you think he should choose as Vice President? What are your top few picks?
Proven governor, outstanding senator, heartland of America. What do you think?
I'll give you my top two. Rob Portland, who's a very good friend, he'd be tremendous. And Marco Rubio. Those would be my top two. Probably his too, but he might have a top five.
Maybe Governor Downland.
There you go.
What do you think?
He's running for re-election, so I don't know.
Yeah. And he's doing a great job.
Well, great. Well, thank you very much for your time today, Senator and Senator Hoeven.